year and a half, and we're one of the founding organizations in the campaign to shut down Rikers. We stand with all the organizations here today against Trump because white supremacist incitement to violence has no place in our city. We will defend ourselves against it by any means necessary. We have to do it ourselves because we know these cops who kill the streets are not out here to protect us. They don't protect and serve us. They protect and serve Trump. They protect and serve Wall Street. It's in our hands, no one else's. So we want to let the whole country know, we want to let the whole world know that although Trump comes from here, there is no place for him here. At the same time, Millions March wants to be crystal clear that our denouncement of Trump's racism is no endorsement of any Democrat. They are also owned and operated by the 1%, and they also are called white supremacy. They're just more subtle about it, and that only makes them more dangerous. They support many of the same policies we fight against. From Bill Clinton overseeing the largest increase in prison population in U.S. history, to Hillary Clinton saying that she's going to build a wall, to Barack Obama setting the record, all-time record for deportations of immigrants, over 2 million in less than 8 years. We have to fight against all these policies, no matter what color the fences that are behind them. Because that's what's happening more and more. Here in New York, Norman Seabrook, a black man who runs the local prison guard union, tried to say Black Lives Matter meets Black Corrections Officers Lives Matter. He celebrates people of color being the guards who hold our people captive on Rikers Island. But as Dora Neale Hurston said, all my skin folk ain't kin folk. We're not gonna allow sellouts like Norman Seabrook, like the Black District Attorney, Ken Thompson, who says no jail time for Peter Liang, to pretend like they stay with our movement. We have to stop believing that black people who join the racist system are gonna protect us. That's not why they're there. They're there to maintain our oppression. We can't trust them. We have to build our own organization that is gonna fight for us, because that's the only way of change that's ever gonna come. When black and brown are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up like that!
What do we do?
Stand up like that!
What do we do?
Stand up like that!
Thank you so much, Camille! All right, I want you guys to welcome our next speaker and the translator, okay? So this is Ella Mendoza from the Ice Free NYC Coalition. Give us a hug!
La migra, la misma porquería.
La migra, la misma porquería.
La policía,
la migra, la misma porquería.
La policía,
la migra, la misma porquería.
Hi, I'm free. Hi, I'm here. Okay. Aquí ahorita estoy yo representando los ilegales de los Estados Unidos.
We are here today representing those marginalized migrant communities in the United States. Illegal.
Y nosotros estamos aquí para decirles que no miramos sus fronteras. No reconocemos sus fronteras.
We are here today to tell you, fuck your borders. We do not see your boundaries. We will not stop fighting. fighting till we, as indigenous people, reclaim our land as Black Lives Matter, and not just as a saying, as a fucking culture, as being aware that these racist structures are killing our people, our marginalized community. We are here, black and brown, to unite, to fight back, and not fucking take any of this bullshit. We do not accept your whitewashed culture. We are free. Yes. Give us up.